Let's look at stock valuation for weighted average method. The same scenario as I have presented for FIFO method. Scenario 1, the same as the other FIFO and LIFO method as well. So we put the opening balance at this side. The second scenario, you can see the calculation for this method is a bit different. When you purchase additional 100 units at the price of 12, you can see the way they get the pricing is to sum up the total cost and the total quantity. Total cost divided by total quantity, you get the new price per unit. The cost per unit price is 10 ringgit and 67 cents. So this is the combination of goods A and B to get the new price. When we proceed to scenario 3, you can see how they utilize this value. Scenario 3, the units issued 260 based on the new price, which is 10 ringgit 67 cent, we derive from this calculation. So 300 minus issued 260, we have balance of 40 units based on the new price, 10 ringgit 67, that we have calculated, combination of A and B as well. We proceed to scenario 4. Additional of 200 unit, we move here to get the new price as well. We will add the previous stock value we have, 40 and 10 ringgit 67 cents, plus the new stock 240 and the total cost 3227. When it divides, you can get 13 ringgit 45 cents is the new price. Combination of ABC goods. Let's proceed to the last scenario. You can see when we issue 190 units, also based on the new price calculation, the balance is 240 minus 190, you get 50 units times the new pricing. The new value for weighted average is 673 for the closing stock value as at today. The combination is goods A, B, and C price. Okay, thank you so much.